Все может получиться.
Sportbets.com. Уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. Sportbets.com. Живой азарт и холодный расчет.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. We're back once again here at Room on Firin'. When I say we, I mean Vendetta and myself. Vendetta, how are you doing?
I'm doing swell right now. I'm really looking forward to some good games.
Excellent. Definitely going to be interesting tonight. And obviously, Semler, well, he had some other plans tonight, which is all right. We did have a pretty crazy day yesterday of about 12 hours of streaming, and then we had that same thing on Saturday, so it was basically 24 hours of streaming in 2 days, which is pretty cool. So it's all right. He gets to have a bit of a day off, and we get to enjoy a couple of matches here. Not so many, but four matches in the SLTV Starseries. First of which is NaVi Berzerk. Then after that, we have NaVi VODS Pro, which is actually going to be a really fun match. Then we have NaVi Mouse Sports, which could turn into almost anything, I imagine. And then we have NaVi versus Reason. So actually, it's just all NaVi all the way. There is another game, of course, which is ESC versus Reason. I realize a lot of you wanted us to do that game because it's on CSGO Lounge, and, you know, generally people would like to watch the match that they have bet on, which I understand, but I think we can't really... I mean, what do you think, Ven? Picking ESC Reason over NaVi VODS Pro, that doesn't seem reasonable, does it?
It really doesn't. And also, we had a nice NaVi theme going on if we picked NaVi versus VP. So,
yeah,
so many things, you know, edging us towards picking the NaVi VP game. And I think most people are more interested to see NaVi VP. Not, you know, nothing against ESC or Reason, but it's NaVi VP.
Exactly. I mean, it's definitely very exciting. So I don't think we can just easily skip that one. And I'm sure someone else will be covering. You can obviously still follow that match if I can figure out what the result is in the ESC Reason game. But yeah, I think that's the most reasonable choice. And look at it this way, guys. ESC and NaVi and VODS Pro are going to be, you know, at the major tournaments coming up soon. So if you want a chance to learn about how these teams are doing after they've been on break, especially maybe VODS Pro, then, you know, consider this a bit of an investment into that. You'll get to figure out sort of firsthand just exactly how good they are. Right now we're waiting for the actual server to be up and running, and then we should be good to go. Webcam isn't working right now because I'm trying to change some stuff in my room, basically, because the green screen is not really working the way I want it to. Actually, now we have something going on the server, so good news. We can switch it on over, and then we should be able to join at the very least. Yeah, there we are. The players are actually on as well, so things are going in the right direction here, which is good news. This upcoming game, Vendetta, I mean, it's... we say Berserk, but actually they're called Penta Esports now, so I guess we should... But just Penta Sports, so I suppose we should really call them by that name. That's more reasonable. And they're playing NaVi. I really have a hard time seeing Penta beating NaVi here.
Well, I'm assuming you had the same feeling going into NaVi versus LC.
No, actually I didn't.
I had really? The same. You expected LC to beat?
No, but I thought there was a chance. I really did.
Okay. But well, I appreciate that being a fellow Norwegian.
No, I actually was not as surprised as most people were. I was surprised, but I wasn't blown away. I was much more surprised by ESG losing to that team. That really completely threw me.
I can agree with that. But yeah, I'd say it's fairly obvious that NaVi are the big favorites coming into this game. But we've seen, well, Berzerk, now Penta, upset teams previously. They are that kind of a team who could potentially make NaVi go the distance.
I mean, let's hope so, because these are best of one games, so it's kind of all or nothing. And for a best of one game, an online game as well, you might as well be on Dust 2, right? It's a pretty good map if you want to upset another team. So we'll have to see. NaVi have been looking a little bit shaky recently as well. I mean, they are, I would say, on an individual basis. If you match any one player to any one player on Penta, NaVi comes out on top all the way.
So, yeah, but I'd agree with that.
That doesn't actually always mean they're going to win. I mean, that's I guess, the funny thing about Counter-Strike, isn't it? Sometimes that's not enough.
Yeah, it really isn't. And that kind of emphasizes how important team play and having good communication and actually gelling as a unit is to CS, and or is to being successful. Obviously, NaVi are doing a great job at that. They obviously play really well together. But I think for a team like Penta, they have to be an absolute perfect cohesion to beat a team like NaVi. But and it's possible, which is what's so cool about CS.
It definitely is. Well, we're going to find out. We do have actually 9 players on. We're just missing one more, and I think that's Crystal waiting to join, probably.
Yeah, I think he is either... they say validating. I'm not sure if they're using ESL Wire, but it might be verifying his integrity cache or whatever it's called.
Yeah,
whenever Steam messes up, you do that, and all of a sudden everything works again.
That's probably it. All right, so Crystal's actually a bit of a mystery to me, because in the sort of middle to early 2013, last year,
yeah,
Crystal was playing in various different German teams, and actually we saw some sick AWP action from him, like really sick. And I sort of expected if he keeps playing like this, well, you know, he's going to be a really scary AWPer. But now, I don't know why, but it feels like he's flatlined on that, you know, progression. He's just at the same level, it feels like, to me. I don't know why.
Well, I think that's actually, I guess you could call it a common curse for a lot of German players. Obviously, you didn't follow the CSS scene as much as I did. But at the beginning of CSGO, Alternate Attacks had a player called MNL in their team. And he was also an extremely good offer from CSS, and was one of those players that I expected to do extremely well in CSGO. And he just kind of, like Crystal, kind of flatlined after a while. And I'm not really sure why that is, because they still do really well at German tournaments, like the EPS finals and that kind of stuff. But they're just not able to do it on a consistent basis, because we do have those games every now and again where Crystal goes off for 30 frags versus a team that, well, Penta normally wouldn't beat, right? And Crystal just goes ham and they win the game.
Exactly.
Yeah, but it's the consistency that is the issue, and I don't really know why that is, but yeah, it's just a thing with German players, it seems. Well, not exclusively to German players, but yeah.
Yeah, well, now we're talking about them. I mean, I don't know. Alexara, on the other hand, I had never heard about until he joined the previous Berserk lineup, now Penta Esports, but he seems to be playing really well. I like his style in general so far, so I'm hoping we can see some cool stuff from him today. If you are just joining us now, welcome to the show. This is Penta Sports versus NaVi, SLTV Starseries Season 10. You're at Room on Fire. I'm Anderson, with me is Vendetta, of course, Semler, taking a bit of a break this evening, which is all right. We streamed for basically 24 hours yesterday, or, you know, the past 2 days, so it's been a little bit crazy. And, yeah, he had some plans anyway, so it kind of fit all together. We do have some cool games coming up for you tonight. And again, a big thanks to the whole subscriber team, which grew massively yesterday. We had a crazy amount of people subscribing, and we definitely appreciate it. Hope you guys are enjoying your time talking in the chat, and hopefully we can... I don't know, continue to grow that team and get better and better. I think we also hit 151,000 followers on the channel itself, so that's really cool and something we obviously appreciate as well. Knife round, not really too exciting here on Dust 2, I would say, but we'll have to see. I hope Penta can get off to a good start, because if they do, then, you know, maybe they can shake NaVi up. NaVi seem to be a bit of an emotional team recently, I say.
Yeah, I think that's actually a pretty common thing for a lot of the CIS teams. They are extremely hard to beat when they're on their game, but if things doesn't really go quite as planned, they have the potential to really just crumble under pressure. That's kind of also what makes them so exciting to watch, because you're not really sure who's going to show up at the major events. Is it going to be the superb version that are definitely going to make a semifinals, or are you going to see the team that's going to go out in the group stages?
Yeah, exactly. And also, who from NaVi is going to be showing up? If it's Guardian, well, you know, we've seen what he can do just on an individual basis, but sometimes Seast is the guy, and sometimes it's Edward, and I don't know, it's just very all over the board for NaVi. And then she said it could be kind of good or bad. I like this play from Penta. They're rushing up the middle, but I think they've actually been discovered in what they're up to here. Rack trying to land a shot. He's going to go down to Seized. Not the best start here for the German team. They are definitely the ones who are the underdogs, and they're the ones that need the better start. Also, Solid going to go down now. Crystal, what? Right through the smoke. Alex R and Asmo, and now just Alex left. All right, I can't even call this out quick enough. Guardian with two headshots, and then it's Alex to fall next. So, not really much of a pistol round for the Penta Sports team here, but what do you think about the idea of pushing up that aggressively in middle?
I liked it. It was a really cool initial idea, and I think the only issue with it, obviously one of them got caught off on short, but I don't think that was a big problem. I think Asmo, who actually got undetected pretty much into T-spawn outside of cave, he should have ran back to mid earlier to actually help out when basically all of Navi's intention was on Crystal in mid. He could have probably picked up one or two easy frags that way.
Haha, Asmo with a sick 1D is going to take down C. So I think you're right. If he had come back to help, it would have maybe been a little bit better. But it's a good start to this round anyway. Are they going to be flashed in? Yeah, flash goes in. Asmo wants to go for the peak, looking for another shot here on Guardian, who's actually going to be dropping fairly low. Now Starix wants to come and help out, and they're actually going to bait Crystal out there. That's pretty smart. Guardian empties his rifle, and then they think, all right, someone must be reloading, and then Starix is there to pick it up. So it's good news, but look at how much damage Navi are taking here.
Yeah, Penta are doing a really good job of stressing Navi out. They're basically pushing from every possible angle at the same time.
And Rack is going to take down Starix in the middle. Really good Nova shotgun action. Actually leaves Penta at a man advantage here. 3-on-4. Flashbang, no, not going to come in. Edward takes down one, but Seuss is going to go down from one body shot here from Asmo. And Asmo knows it. Oh, he's not going to be able to pick it up. Oh, if he had hit that shot, that would have been different. Now Edward looking to secure the situation here from Navi. But Penta Esports coming up with a really, really good second round already, and Alex has armor and an AK here. It's going to go down.
Yeah, really nice tendency coming out from Penta. I like the fact that there was kind of an unending aggression from them and that eco. And they actually put Navi on notice. They were down to, what, I think two of the players remaining had 20 HP or less.
Yeah.
So that could have easily turned. I think Asmo got in a bit of an awkward situation because he knew Edward was pushing up towards shorts. He kind of had to take the battle at long, which didn't really favor him. But if he gets that frag, I think that's an easy round for Penta, actually.
Yeah, I agree. You're picking up that frag, picking up the AK that would have fallen down there, that would have been a major big deal. Then Edward would actually be the only one with any health left on Navi. So, yeah, I definitely agree. That was really close, actually. So we'll see if they can change it around. Obviously, this round, they don't really have anything. Nothing like the last round. No deagles, just a standard pistol. Actually, Asmo does have a deagle, so he's really feeling it here. He's going to be the only one left fighting Edward over by long. And I think Edward even knows he's there.
Yeah, he definitely has a hunch. I don't think... Oh, actually, no.
Oh! 1, 2, and 3. There we go. Edward is down, and Asmo picks up an AK. Could take down Guardian here, definitely be a huge kill coming in, and he will do it. Well played, Asmo. This is a really good play. He's going to throw away the AK. He feels like he's going to die, and he doesn't want them to pick it up in return. So obviously, Seized wouldn't be able to anyway, but that is actually pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. And I think he might have expected Guardian to have something as well for him to pick up. I'm not really sure, even though Guardian was shooting with the USP, but yeah. In any case, I think you're right when you're saying that he probably expected to die.
It's going to put us right into the fourth round. AWP pick up on Alex, not Crystal, which is actually something we've seen before from the former Berserk team, now called Penta Sports. But it still catches me off guard because, as I said, I've always been looking for Crystal to be the one doing the AWPing on these German teams here. Oh, in the middle, Guardian goes down. Good start from Alex. That is what you need. If you can kill Guardian in an AWP duel, you know you're doing something right.
Yeah, and I really like the fact that he bounced that smoke off into lower, basically securing himself, making that peak, which is pretty aggressive, still really safe for him, unless some of the Navi players just happen to randomly shoot him through smoke.
Good boost in the middle here. Seuss is going to go down. They're trying to see if they can return fire, but it's nowhere near enough. Solik down to 41, so it's a really good start there. Unfortunately, they run into a grenade, which brings Solik and Crystal even lower. But this is still a really advantageous position coming out here from Penta. See if they can actually make something off it. Where is Alex? He's kind of in the wrong position for the B push that Navi is doing, but Solik, actually it's both Solik and Crystal are here. They're the two low players.
I think the plus side is that Crystal is in a really good spot right now. So unless Edward instantly takes him out, this is going to be a round for Penta.
Yeah, and Edward actually scopes up, but he looks away just as Crystal peeks. Now, he's going to duck up again. He's trying to pick the shot in here and doing a lot of damage to Na'Vi as well. Crystal with a great shot. Edward, way too late with that pickoff. Now he's alone here with just 15 seconds, and he should probably just either save the orb or go for the kills, and he's going to choose to do the latter of that. So fair enough. They're coming for him, jumping around there. Both missing shots. 6 seconds. He's going to have to either live or die right here. This is really dangerous for Edward. Potentially a big upset here if Na'Vi are going to lose this. Throwing the rifle away, and he's going to go down after the time runs out. So Edward is down to 2100, where everyone else on Na'Vi could have bought anyway. So that's a big mistake.
Yeah, that's... Well, basically, Edward didn't get the pick he needed on Crystal early on, and that's kind of what broke the round for Na'Vi. And they're actually opting to not drop the AK for Edward. They decide to drop a op for Guardian, and that kind of works out already.
Yeah, Alex wanted to go for a Smith type peek where you just throw a flashbang over the middle and then, you know, peek right after it pops. It's a really good idea, but Guardian this time was a little bit too fast, and I guess... Oh, okay. Sick shot coming out from Solid. Takes down Seized. Up on short now. It's Rack waiting. Seuss is walking in here. Rack, I think he spotted the top of the head there. Oh, he's almost dead, and he's going to go down, and that actually loses him the A-bomb sign, and this is not a good position. Are they going to go for it here, or are they going to run away, do you think?
Save. I think this is a way too awkward situation to actually retake from, and Na'Vi are going to have four people on site. They're going to have... so much room to actually get into pretty decent afterplant position, so I think the best Penta can do is save their weapons.
I like the idea that they didn't buy anything for Edward. I think that's the right move. You know, he goes over and throws away, you know, that the money. He has to learn somehow, right? You know, if you buy for him, that's just not, you know, not right.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Flashbang comes in. It's going to take down one here. Starix up on short. It's going to go down as well. Now it's Edward and Guardian left. And Edward with an orb as well. Going to pick down one. Guardian actually missing a shot here. And Edward missing one. It's just going to be Asmo left. And he goes down. So it's a triple for Guardian. And they get to save two orbs. And actually, no, they throw one away. Edward doesn't want it.
And I'm actually really surprised that Penta went for that. They would have been perfectly fine just saving those three weapons. And instead, they... go really late. I'm not really sure how they would have fared in actually defusing the bomb if they managed to clear out the site, because they definitely would have had to put in work to get down Guardian and Edward in that situation.
Yeah. Guardian looking for the pick here, not quite getting the timing down, and he did have a really close long spawn there. Sonic in the middle trying to play a little bit of a ninja game here, hiding in the smoke close to doors. It's actually kind of a cool idea, I think.
Yeah, it's similar to what he did in the pistol round, actually, or Crystal did in the pistol. Didn't work out quite too well for Crystal that time, though.
No. Na'Vi, I mean, 4-1 is a decent start, but I think Penta has already shown us that they can definitely fight back, and that one pickoff that they got that round against the Guardian was obviously big, so if Alex can come up with a couple of rounds like that in this first half, there's a chance they can actually do something here.
Oh, absolutely. And they have a pretty nice stack towards the bomb site here, though. Rack gets taken out and Crystal follows suit. And now all of a sudden everything's just kind of unraveling for Penta.
Yeah, not looking all too good. Asmo doesn't get the Deegan this time either. Edward with a triple, and he's down to 12 HP as well. It's a little bit of a shame he doesn't go down, because Na'Vi is starting to build some sort of bank here. I mean, 6,000 on Edward. He's also top fracking with 8, 1, and 2. He's doing a fine job at the moment. We're moving into the 7th round, and there is going to be a double up, and it's still not Crystal. It's Solik and Alex, so I'm still intrigued by all of this.
I'm a bit surprised, actually, because Crystal could easily held down B, more or less alone, with an op. I think he's good enough to do that, but it seems like Penta wants to op for mid-control instead with Solik.
Yeah, apparently they do, and, well, he's actually going to be all the way up in the window, so I guess, yeah, he can look down towards middle. Asmo thinking about pushing up, and they have Alex to cover him, so this is kind of a cool idea. I think if Na'Vi want to go long and they push through the doors, they're going to maybe lose one, or at least maybe they're just going to be watching for Alex, and then they won't be thinking about Asmo in this corner, so that's a good idea, but long is not the object right now for Na'Vi.
No, this is typical Na'Vi, really. Basically just biding their time, getting a good feel for how Penta are playing each and every round, and it seems like this might be a B-split.
Yeah, it definitely feels like it. That smoke and spawn, though, is going to disappear, so they're going to have to put up a new one, I think. And is it going to happen? There's the smoke. Rack can't really see anything. It's going to be up to Crystal up in the doors here. Rack just charges through, takes down one and two, and Na'Vi not turning around for it. That's obviously a big mistake coming out here from the terrorist side, and that's going to bite them. Rack with a triple kill. Very nicely done. He's going to go down eventually, but that was definitely something. And it's going to be up to Crystal and Solik to finish the round. What a push through from Rack.
Yeah, that was a bit of a ball. It's a BDP. That's definitely what it was. And I'm surprised NaVi didn't commit more people out to mid. They basically had two people run out by themselves into mid, get caught out by Rack, and then group number two comes out. So that was a bit of an odd decision and a weird execute really from NaVi, and it didn't really work out either. But yeah, definitely. Great job from Rack.
Yeah, that was really nice. I mean, it is a big risk taking, running through that smoke. Even if you flash your way through, it's still a pretty big risk. So the fact that he got two kills, then ran back through the smoke and got another one through the smoke was pretty impressive. Now NaVi have gone for a buy here that actually completely depletes their bank, and it's what, four rifles and one Tech 9. Are they just going to walk out? I think they're just going to walk out the middle. Yeah, and now Rack is going to peek, takes down one, he spots everyone else, and Solik's up here, going to be dropping Seuss, takes another peek, misses that one, and Rack is going to be his turn again right through the smoke. He's ready for it. This time not quite hitting the shot. Seuss is going to come in from Upper Dark as well, and Solik goes down inside the bomb site. Crystal will be dropped, and this is a big problem here for Penta. They really can't afford to lose this round. They don't have that much money. And now V, they're going to get the bomb plant at least.
Yeah, this is going to be a hard hold up.
Yeah, especially with flashbangs like that. Oh my god, Asmo! One and two, the last one. Great headshot on Edward. Those flashbangs were uncharacteristically good, I think. That was really impressive.
Yeah, they were highly effective, which is something you don't see too often on that B-bomb site. It's probably one of the hardest sites to retake in all of CS. So it definitely shows that Penta have been working on their flashes. And it looked really sketchy for them for a moment there. I was sure that Rack would at least pick up one more kill, or that Guardian would go down in mid earlier, but that didn't happen. Crystal getting picked off by Zeast, coming, gunning in with the Tech 9. Didn't look too well for them, but they managed to bring it back.
Yeah, I actually thought that retake was going to be much, much tougher for Penta, just because it's the B-bomb site. Even if NaVi didn't have that much equipment, I still felt like, just running through the window when someone's looking, even if they're blind, sometimes you can just go down anyway, so it's a little bit tricky.
Yeah, I realize. I think the biggest, factor against NaVi in that situation was the fact that they didn't really have any nades of their own to hold Penta back, so they'd have to use more flashes or just simply waste their flashes.
Yeah, running out into the middle, NaVi did actually invest into some smokes and grenades here, but once again, Rack is really clever here. He's taking up position right at the edge of the smoke, making sure that he doesn't get blocked out and he can help Solik out. So Guardian here, well, he doesn't even have anything. He really wanted to pick up that rifle, I think, but they're denying it. Rack making sure it's not going to happen. Finally picks it up and it's going to get a great headshot in right there. Can they reload? That's the big question here. Guardian needs some time. And there's going to be the reload. Don't think he can put the bomb down. If he can get one more kill in here, it's going to be a really big round for NaVi. It's already a good round, but it would be huge if he can get one more kill.
Yeah, and I like that Penta are playing this passively. They're just basically waiting to hear the sound from Guardian putting down the bomb.
Yeah. Oh, what? He fakes it with a pistol. Ah, nice play from Guardian there. Has an AWP of his own. He's going to be spawning really far away from mid, though. And that could be a problem if Penta are going to be there faster. Oh, nobody taking any kills here. Re-peeking, Guardian walking and shooting. And Alex actually, or Solik that was, sorry, a little bit slow on the trigger there.
I think he was looking for the, clean shot. But Alex equalizes it to one man down each.
Yeah, NaVi being much more aggressive than they normally would be over on long there. Just taking the challenge in a way they maybe shouldn't have, I think. Because what were they hoping to gain, really? Apart from getting the kill, but they already had one kill.
They've probably been made aware of the fact that Asmo has been playing the long area fairly aggressively up till this point, so they might have wanted to snuff him out before he actually got the opportunity to get into cave.
It could be. Oh, Guardian missing a shot. It's going to be Crystal in the back here. Not a great position for him now. Got to be really careful. He's trying to play this game, but they're all shooting at him. But the longer this takes, the worse it's going to be. Starix will take down Rat coming through the doors. Crystal so low on health. One grenade is going to be enough here, and they will take him down. Now Alex and Asmo. 2-on-4 here. I would not recommend going for this one unless they can pick up a kill right here, and they're going to miss the shot. I think they should fall back here.
Yeah, they definitely should. And I'm actually surprised their rotation was so late. Because Crystal had information that at least 3 Na'Vi players were coming towards that B area a long, long time ago.
Yeah, I don't know what that was. I mean, Crystal did a good job. He didn't get any kills, but just staying alive as long as he did, I guess that did buy the time you're talking about there.
Yeah, obviously I think Rack going down to, I think it was Starix, who got that kill as he ran in towards the B bomb site. I think obviously that was an issue, but I think by that time, Penta should already had at least one more guy nearby the B bomb site, but instead the rotation took way too long, and Crystal had done everything it could do in that situation, really. So he had no opportunity to actually buy any more time.
So the big thing here, of course, is that they saved the one AWP. They could have maybe saved two, but one of them got taken down in the T-spawn. And everyone else can still buy on Penta. So they have one more chance here to make something happen. But if they lose this round, they're going to be ecoing for quite a while. Alex looking for the shot over here. And Guardian was actually running towards long, but he's going to be falling back immediately. Doesn't want to take the fight. So I don't know. I'm actually pretty impressed by the way Penta are playing so far. I think they're doing a good job.
Yeah, their CT set is really nice, and I wouldn't be surprised if Na'Vi actually try to go towards, or try for another B split, because I think they are very aware of how Penta are playing, because Penta are doing the same setup pretty much every round. They're leaving Catwalk uncontested, and Rack is basically holding for CT spawn every single round, and I think Na'Vi knows that, but ooh, we're actually seeing a pretty cool push from Penta here on B.
I was about to say they're determined to try and prove you wrong, because just as you were saying, they're doing a lot of the same stuff. Now they're actually switching it up, and this push is going to be golden. Solid walking right down here. He's going to see Seized and should be able to take him down. Seized ducking. Oh, what? He's alive still. Now grenade to follow. Solid is going to take some damage in return. It's still a lot of information here from Penta, but that is definitely a big missed opportunity.
Oh, definitely. That should have been a kill. That was the most primed kill I've ever seen. That was unfortunate for the Germans, but Na'Vi look a little bit lost right now, and it seems like they're going to try for the B-split after all.
In the middle, Solid goes down, and now in Upper Dark, they still have Crystal. Rack wants to come through here and be the hero again, which is not easy. Doing it once is hard. Doing it twice is a bit of a fantasy almost. Rack goes down. Crystal, oh, great 180, but he's still going to get caught in the end. 10 seconds left. Na'Vi, they can't win the round anymore. There's no time unless they can find Asmo. Oh, what painful loss for Na'Vi and Penta. I think they may have been sacrificing the right animals here to the gods, because that is definitely a round that they were not meant to win.
And all of that because of Solik's botched opportunity. That's actually really weird how that played out, because Na'Vi were definitely lost for words. That's kind of a bad way to put it, but they definitely had no idea what they wanted to do when Solik caught Seized off guard there. So they just completely abolished their plans towards for an A push and just rotated over towards B, because they knew that the B players were out of position. But it all took too much time, and I think Crystal doing a great job picking up those two frags and dropping the bomb as well on Cease. That was probably the biggest thing.
Guardian also missing a couple of shots over on long here, which, you know, if anyone else had done it, it wouldn't be such a big deal, but Guardian normally is very good at hitting those shots when people are jumping by like that, so that they can't afford right now. I mean, 5-6 is actually a pretty good score for Penta. I think because they're playing Na'Vi, I'd like to see them get up to around 6 or 7 rounds in the first half, even though that sounds like a lot. But I think that if they do that, then they're actually in position to maybe be able to upset this game. It would be a big upset if they do it.
Well, they do have the opportunity to actually force Na'Vi into an eco. If they win this round and deny the bomb plant, this should be at least 7 rounds for Penta.
Crystal back here again, see if he can buy time like he did last time. They're going to be peeking out here. He does some good damage. He's going to flash in, and Solid is right here. Grenade to follow. Na'Vi charges through. Solid goes down. Crystal with a 1, with a 2, with a triple. Edward is down, and now it's on Seuss to fall next. Guardian in the back here is finally going to get the kill, but this is happening much too late. Guardian is going to charge through and go down. Rack with the easy kill picked up here. 6-6. No bomb plant and no money for Na'Vi. And things are starting to look really scary now for Na'Vi, I'd say.
Yeah, and again, really good job by Crystal. And he's utilizing the fact that he can, well, a couple of months back, I guess it's closer to a year, Navi, or Valve, implemented this delay to crouching. So you wouldn't be able to do kind of what Crystal was doing there, which is basically spam crouch to get peek and being able to pull out, or, you know, shoot out a couple of bullets and then go back to hiding. But that delay is cancelled whenever you move.
Hmm, yeah.
So, Crystal playing that smartly.
Definitely doing a good job. Rat goes down, but, you know, this is, I guess, great for Na'Vi if they can get a bunch of kills in here and try and weaken Pence's economy, because it's already not looking so good, but it's just Edward and Guardian left. Edward does have a Deagle, and I don't know, the CIS team really needs to rethink what they're doing here, because Penta are certainly ready for them.
They definitely are, and they're playing really well. Even though they're pretty much, as you can see if you look at the overview, it's pretty much the same setup every single round, but they're executing it well, and that's why it's working.
Yeah, it is really definitely working. Alex here, gotta be careful he doesn't get shot, but he's gonna peek out middle and easy kill on Guardian. Now Edward really wants that last one dig in on someone, but he's gonna get taken down. Alex not letting him play that game. Triple for Alex, and right now, I mean, Guardian is top fragging with 14 kills. It's actually not even that that Na'Vi is behind on kills. I mean, looking at the scoreboard, it's pretty much even, so I don't even know what's winning. Penta are just, they're just having some really good pickoffs here, and Na'Vi keep trying for that B bomb site, and it's not working so well.
Yeah, it really isn't. And I actually think the reason why the scoreboard looks a bit weird is because we had that one round with Na'Vi basically running out of time with three players alive. And how was that three down? How was it not a hit?
Don't know. I was going to say Edward should be dead right now. This should be another great opening for Penta. Oh, that's a little bit painful. The best Na'Vi can shoot for right now is making this 8-7, which means they're still perfectly in the game, but it's definitely not the kind of score that we would expect. Alex going to be walking up here. Na'Vi takes a loss early on. Seuss is going to go down, and it's just Alex doing a hell of a lot of work with this AWP early in the rounds.
Yeah, I mean, really, he should have had two entries by now.
Down in pit, Asmo takes a good headshot there, gonna get a second one. And actually, that was a grenade. Well played. This German team is playing much better than last time we saw them. Guardian is alone here. No chance at all. I mean, he's charging in, and even if he gets a couple of kills here, not gonna make a big difference in the long run. Asmo doing a good job of just hiding, and Guardian missing a lot of shots here that really normally he wouldn't. Finally gonna pick up one, turns around, and Asmo is gonna go down as well. Are they really gonna challenge Guardian once more? Don't wanna make this into a one-on-one. Flashes his way in. Not sure he realizes Crystal's up here, so that might be the end of him. Guardian goes down, and it will be 8-6 here, and final round coming up.
And Na'Vi have to do a pretty awful buy. Obviously, they're going to force up with everything we got, but it's going to be Galils and Deagles.
Yeah, not too exciting, is it? I mean, two Galils here. I mean, they've had, well, normally when we talk about Na'Vi, we talk about the Orb on Guardian as being one of the big factors. So when they don't even have that, it's kind of hard to get too excited about two Galils and a couple of pistols here. 9-6 would be a sick score for Penta early on here. All right, in the middle, Solik is another double up setup here, and the Germans, they're too strong.
Yeah, they're just doing a really good job of shutting down everything Na'Vi attempts to. This is actually, I expect them to have a shot if they play well, but this is looking really, really solid for Penta.
It absolutely is. Yeah, I mean, second half is a different question altogether. We're going to have to see if the Germans can keep up what they've been doing so far on the CT side. And it's a little bit different playing the CT side, so it could be that they are not going to be quite as effective, but the lead that they've generated so far should carry them quite a long ways. 9-6 for the first half here. And Na'Vi just, I mean, it was looking actually pretty good early on, so I won't even say that Na'Vi were just completely fumbling all of this. I just think they were caught off guard by how well Penta played.
What I think was really cool about how Penta played it is that you never really saw, I think one round Na'Vi had a successful A push, or A split A push, a take towards the A bomb site, really. Just one time through that entire first half. And that just speaks volumes of how well Penta did to actually shut them down before they got into favorable positions. And that's obviously all on Penta. That's Penta basically just disrupting Na'Vi from playing what they feel is a comfortable style of playing. And with Rack doing such a massive job in the middle area at the beginning, when Na'Vi were basically trying to be split every single round, it seemed like Na'Vi kind of ran out of options after a while.
Wait, did you get the feeling that maybe Na'Vi took a little bit too long to realize that B-split wasn't working at all?
Well, I actually think what NaVi did was perfectly okay, because I think they were fully aware of that Rack was holding position X and CT spawn, and he's gonna hold this angle and he's gonna do this and that. It's just the fact that Rack was able to kill people faster than the NaVi players, which sounds really dumb, I guess, but it's actually that easy. NaVi can probably do that, or they would probably do that a lot more rounds if we had played, let's say, MR30. If this has been a 30 round first half, they would probably do that a ton of more times, because they have all the information necessary to really work with and to make a B split work. It's just that Rock and Solik and Crystal towards that B area and mid did a really good job of shutting NaVi down before they could get any sort of momentum on their pushes.
It's true, but I think there were some common themes in this. One of them was Rack playing the middle really well. I mean, that was definitely credit to him. Crystal played this back box by B really good, but he played it well, but this is a position that could be dealt with in a number of different ways, and it seemed like NaVi, they elected to deal with this position by trying to out-aim him, just waiting for him to peek his head up and take a headshot, and they could have done different things, I expect, like a smoke, for instance, to try and make sure that Crystal would have had a harder time doing anything. Sort of felt like maybe NaVi were just a little bit too confident that they could just walk in and pick up the kills like that.
Yeah, maybe, but then again, if you smoke Crystal off in that situation, he has a really small area of space that he has to spam through to connect with any NaVi players. NaVi have absolutely no idea where Crystal is after that fact. After they smoke it off, Crystal is just basically a wild roaming menace that's just waiting to wreak havoc on your team. And I think that's why NaVi much more prefer to have vision and somewhat control over where the various German players are, even though they might not be able to deal with them at that certain moment. They rely on their skills to actually being able to take him out, but you know, it's obviously easier to kill people you can see rather than people you can't see. And the same thing goes for running into tunnels and trying to nade him out, which is obviously another opportunity, but you're also very susceptible to actually just dying.
Yeah, I was going to say, running with grenades is really dangerous, especially if you're multiple people, because the first guy gets shot, then the grenade falls to its ground, and you blow up your whole team. So I'm glad they didn't try for the grenade option. I think just maybe smoking could have given them a little bit of a room to work with. You're smoking and flashing through the smoke like that, so Crystal just peeks into a flash, and I don't know, I'm not saying that would have been the absolute answer, but maybe something could have worked out. Now Rush coming to the bombsite, he has seized 1, 2, 3, Seuss with a kill as well, and it's going to be one for Edward in the meantime, and just Rag left here, looking a little bit tough for him. Seized will actually get his triple kill, all of them headshots. What a complete mow down. They just lined up for Edmundetta. I mean, there's nothing even to talk about then, that was just a pure execution.
That was a pretty solid pistol play coming out from NaVi, and that's, you know, both gun rounds won, or pistol rounds won for NaVi, and they're still behind.
Interestingly, because I think the statistics that that Lopez drew up at one point last year, even I think it was when he was, you know, pointing out that if you win both pistol rounds, there's a really good chance you can actually just end up with, I think it's like a 70-80% chance of winning.
Yeah, something crazy.
It's a really high chance. I think it's like 78% chance. I mean, it's quite ridiculous. Interesting ninja play coming out from Guardian, who just had a pistol, so there was almost no risk. I mean, all he would have lost was a body armor, but he picks up a kill and runs away, grinning in the night. I mean, that was almost ridiculous, wasn't it?
It was really well done. Not a big of a fan that he's rocking the pistol only, but he made it work.
Yeah, Seuss up here on towards Goose and spots a lot of people coming in. Should actually get some backup pretty quickly here, otherwise he's going to get double teamed. He's going to pick up a kill before he goes down, but he was very much alone in that position. Up in the bomb site, Crystal, Solik is actually going to be able to put down the bomb, so a big victory here for Penta. Very nicely played round already. They are going to lose it, but two kills and a bomb plant. Great success for the German team, no doubt about that.
Yeah, they have to be ecstatic with that. Pretty nifty shot from Crystal there onto Seuss. But yeah, got the bomb plant, they're definitely happy, and we're probably not going to see a buy coming out of them, because they did invest quite a bit into that eco.
Yeah, you're right. This is something we've been discussing a lot. I think people have different opinions of it. A lot of people say if you can just get like two kills with the armor pistol buy, you've done all right. And I can see where they're coming from, because, you know, even if it's not winning a round, you're still doing a lot of economic damage, but I think three kills or two kills on a bomb plant, that's what I'm looking for. I don't think two kills is quite enough.
I think a bomb plant is definitely the goal whenever you buy up with armor and pistols and eco round, for sure. I think that's the only way you can, we'll call it, a successful eco.
Oh, Aspo, and another one. This is actually really big here. NaVi have just had two rounds where they could have built up a big economy. Instead, they lose an AWP in the middle, which hopefully they're going to be able to recover. And they lose another player in Edward. Zeus is going to make him fly around, and Starseries also can save the AWP. But, I mean, Penta right now have actually paved the way to be able to win just two rounds in a row here, and then they'll be able to buy.
Yeah.
Or they'll be able to force the eco. That's what I meant.
Yeah, and that's obviously, you talked about people having various opinions on whether or not they want to buy up to either get a plan or basically wreak havoc to the opponent's economy, even though the opponents have proper weaponry. And this is why some teams opt to do this, because you could end up in a situation where if you win the third round, instead of the other team being able to have another buy round and basically screw you over money-wise, you're going to do that to them.
Guardian up here, scoped up, they're gonna flash up. Penta, seeing this coming, it's really, really smart play, but are they gonna realize Caesar's there? They do, and take him down. This is actually, I mean, alright, there's a lot happening right here. The German team is not just, they're not just hitting good shots, and they're just capitalizing on the mistakes that NaVi are making. They're also just playing some really intelligent Counter-Strike right now. This is a real pleasure to watch. It's gonna be Guardian alone inside here, and they're not even overcommitting to it. They've just snuck Crystal in, and he's probably gonna pick up a kill here. Guardian, no idea what's happening, and that's the bomb site lost here. Edward tries to take a duel, and all they have to do now is play it safe, Penta, and they should be able to win this round. Edward, no, Zeus peeking in, he's gonna go down. NaVi are losing their minds right now.
Yeah, I have no idea what Zeus was doing there. That definitely cost them the round. I mean, obviously it's not a given that NaVi would have been able to retake this, but that definitely gave it away for Penta. Or for NaVi, I guess.
Yeah, it did. I mean, that was a really clear indication, I would say, that that NaVi are really getting frustrated, because normally those are not the mistakes that you see NaVi make. For Edward to take the peep when they're running in is a little bit different, but for Zeus to run in like that definitely seemed crazy.
Yeah, I think the only justification from Zeus's side would be that he felt he had a chance to deny the bomb plant, which is obviously great. If he could have denied the bomb plant, then sure, I can definitely defend his decision, but he went in really awkwardly and didn't even look towards the bomb site. So I'm not really sure what he was hoping to accomplish.
I really don't know, but at the end of the day, it's Penta who come out on top, and I say again, I was pretty much impressed by the way that that they managed to turn that around, because the position that they had up in upper hallways here, NaVi that is, with the Guardian pushed up, was a really cool one, and yeah, somehow Penta saw it coming.
Yeah, and even though we talked so much about, you know, making the other team feel the pain during even anti-ecos, now they're still able to buy up, and they somehow managed to scratch enough money together for an AWP for Guardian.
Which is good, but it's also an AWP without any kind of body armor at all, so if he catches a grenade or something like that, or a body shot, things are going to be a little bit tricky here. Penta, they don't have a lot of money either. I mean, this is sort of where a lot of the game is decided, and it's going to be Zeus to take down Rack. Drops him in the middle, pushes through, trying to see if he can get another one. He's going to get the one, he's going to get the double, actually, and Seized will pick up one in Asmo. Alex, oh, what a return! It might be too late, but this is really important. NaVi is a team right now that needs a huge economy. They need to build up $6,000, $7,000, $8,000, $9,000, $10,000 on their side so they can afford to lose a couple of rounds and still be able to buy Penta. They're on the more favored side here, and their guns are cheaper generally.
Yeah, I think actually if Alex is able to take out Seize, I think we might see a force buy coming up from Penta, and that could really screw with NaVi.
Oh, he actually went for that quick scope. That was, hey, Alex is on point right now. No doubt about that. It's Crystal top fragging on their team, and Alex is actually down to 10, which is strange, but I feel like all of Alex's 10 kills must have been
impact
either really
frags.
Impressive or really, yeah, entry frags. It's kind of really, really important ones.
Yeah, it's impact frags all the way, and that's also why you shouldn't straight up, you know, judge a player by his stats.
And they don't force it up. They do eat a grenade, and Guardian is going to pick up a quick kill here on Asmo in the middle. So a bit of a, you know, so far at least, a more normal round coming out from NaVi, just being able to take some eco kills. Edward can't see a thing. They don't even realize that Solik ran past them. That was a bit of a penetration play coming out there. Now it's going to be Rack in a 1-on-5 looking for the one kill. That you can get that at least. I mean, it's important for Penta not to allow NaVi to get any rounds here where they have everyone alive. They want to get one or preferably two kills every round. That's not going to happen. Ed will make sure it doesn't. So that's the first time in a while, I think, we can say something positive about NaVi here.
Yeah, well, that's definitely the round they were looking for, and already you see the effect of it. You know, after buying, only Zeus is the one who's somewhat hurting, economically speaking. Even he will be able to buy up in the upcoming round if they lose.
Alright, you are Alex trying to take a blind shot through, and Penta slowing down their round here, not really doing anything crazy. And they've been getting the pick-offs. I mean, NaVi hasn't been the team to get the most picks here, so I don't really blame the terrorist side for actually trying this.
Yeah, what's going to be interesting to see is how Penta decide to really attack NaVi. I think NaVi are one of the better CT-sided teams, regardless of maps, of the top teams. And that's the start.
And there's a second start. Wow, Guardian now has a big task on his hand. He's going to fall back behind the corner here. He has to kill a lot of people before this is going to work out. Instead, he's just going to do some damage, get some damage taken on him instead. And the bomb is all the way back. They're not committing to this. They're just going to leave one guy down in pit. And then I expect they're going to go for a B push instead.
Yeah, they have the nades for it. Or actually, they throw those away. So this is going to be an A play.
Alright, and Seast spots that out, especially because he gets a kill. That's a lot of information. Asmo, actually, now they're going to run back. They realize nobody is at the B bomb site. If Seast is in the middle and there's two people at A, then it's no one left. They're waiting for Seast to come back here. They got to stay alive, all of them here. It's a 3-on-3, and great pickoff from Seast. Now he's going to run right into Solid, pulls out the AWP, misses the shot, and Penta are going to win the round and make it 11-11. And NaVi are going to have to spend their whole bank just making sure they can buy. Now they can't afford to lose more rounds here. That would be devastating.
Yeah, it definitely would. I think for either team, really, a round lost or losing this round means giving up two rounds. It's just that easy. But that was a really... I'm not really sure how that round played out the way it did, but yeah, that was some weird play because we saw Asmo basically having a free path in towards the B bomb site. They actually went back together with Solik to challenge season mid.
I did. One AWP on Guardian here, and I don't know. I mean, I think some of the mistakes we're seeing here is you know, one of the things we were talking about earlier on is how NaVi sometimes can be a bit of an emotional team, and it feels like maybe that's what we're seeing here. Some of these mistakes just not based off of the cool, calm version of NaVi that we sometimes see, but more the slightly scared and maybe a little bit confused NaVi that not too often, but every once in a while sort of peaks out, and this is not the time to do it. I mean, the score is tied. In the second half here, NaVi have actually been looking better than almost they did in the first half, which says a lot.
Yeah, it really, really does. And again, we haven't really seen Penta, I guess, execute a normal round, per se, in a Byron. Oh. And as I say that, I don't think we're going to see that this round either, as Crystal gets picked off by Zeus.
And the most confusing battle down there might as well have been Zeus going down. That was very back and forth. They just ran right past each other in the smoke. Now Guardian is in play. Going to be taking down Alex. And there's still an AWP on Solik up on short here. Guardian does realize now Solik going to peek and take him down. Guardian not on form today, it feels like. But Solik is still going to go down. It's going to be Rack and Asmo left. 2-on-4. And now a 1-on-4 with 8 seconds left. Rack can get the one kill in, and that's about all they get. So two kills here. NaVi now making it 12-11, and things still aren't over. But I don't know. This is a strange game. Either way, no matter what the outcome is here, I'm really pleasantly surprised to see Penta play this well.
Yeah, me too. Me as well. They're doing what we always hope they'll do when we watch them play, because they're either going to get trounced 16-3 or they're going to put up a really good game.
Edward looking down the middle. They are rushing through here. Guardian is helping him out while Edward reloads. It's a bit of a dangerous position because if Guardian doesn't hit that shot and Edward isn't done reloading, they start off by losing a player, and NaVi just need to keep everyone alive for the rest of this half here. Can't lose any players at all. All the economy is what's going to kill NaVi. If they lose this game, it'll be because they have to eco once in the last six rounds here. I think that's basically it.
Yeah, economy is definitely the name of the game at this point for both teams, really. Even though Penta are in a situation where they can afford to buy more often than NaVi, they still can't afford to throw away rounds. So even if they win this upcoming round, they still have to do it in a fairly convincing fashion, because you can see Crystal, he's kitted out with a P250, and that's it.
Yeah, he is. Not a lot. Edward walking right through here without the x-ray. We can see how little he can see, but he's going to spot one guy jumping up. He's waiting for it, and an easy kill for Edward. Though over on long, Guardian still orping down towards the pit here. He's already killed one, and there's just two AKs down there. And oh, he jumps just as they walk in. Grenade is going to follow up here, and one right back in the face of Crystal. Takes a little bit of damage, but this is very likely going to be 14-11 here. And I'm not sure if Penta can really carry this all the way home. It's been so close. They had such a sick first half, they almost deserve to be able to bring it back home. But that's not how the game works, of course.
No, and I guess it kind of speaks volumes to how good of a team Na'Vi are. Because we continue to talk about how many mistakes they're making and how uncharacteristic the play we're seeing from them are. But there's still two rounds up. And about to be three rounds up.
Yeah. That is true, and that's what we were talking about earlier. I mean, I think that might actually be what's making the difference here, because we said individually, just one for one, you match any one player on Na'Vi to any one player on Penta, and Na'Vi's going to come out on top all the time. But Penta has been playing a much better Counter-Strike game, I would say.
Yeah, I think they're playing the team game better.
Yeah.
At this point, I think Na'Vi have been bailed out by Guardian a couple of times, by Edward a couple of times, and seized. Like, every player from Na'Vi has kind of chipped in one round where they are the ones carrying the heavy load.
Now Penta are really... They have the backs against the wall here. Two scouts being picked up. Guardian not impressed. He does get body shot down to 16, but he takes the headshot on Crystal either way. And I guess Penta can buy the last round even if they lose this one, but it won't be an impressive buy. Oh, it will be a really bad buy. I'm sorry, they've only lost three rounds in a row. I thought that was five in a row, so now... How much money are they going to get? Around 2,800 for losing?
And not anything to speak of, so I wouldn't be surprised if we see something similar like double scout or even triple scout and a Galil and casual armor.
Yeah, well... We don't want to rule them out. I think they deserve a little bit of credit for what they've been up to so far. Let's see if they can come up with something really surprising here. Seized in the back. They're running through the smoke, and it's not a good idea. He's going to take down one. Now Scout's waiting, but Edward in this corner is the big player. He's going to get the kill, and then Seized, actually. He's going to be the one coming up with a triple. It puts him up to 25 kills, only outfragged by Guardian at 26. And now it's match and map point for Na'Vi here. They are... They're bringing it back. You got to give them some credit for that. But I'm still not too impressed by Na'Vi here. But maybe it's the first. Maybe they haven't warmed up. I mean, could this be a thing? Do you think maybe they've just come cold into this game and were a little bit rusty?
I definitely think they've played quite a bit before this game started. But I think we have to look at it this way: that we have to give more credit to Penta for actually bringing it to Na'Vi. They're actually forcing a lot of the mistakes that Na'Vi are doing out of them. It's not just blatantly Na'Vi messing up, per se.
And I think, I mean, another big factor actually that you mentioned earlier, but I just forgot in the meantime, is that Na'Vi won both pistol rounds. If Na'Vi had lost one of those pistol rounds, I think Penta could have actually won this game.
Yeah, that's definitely a possibility, because Na'Vi picked up six easy rounds that way.
Yeah, it's six rounds, which is obviously, right now there's a five round difference, but it's not even just that, it's the amount of ecos Na'Vi would have had otherwise if they'd lost one of those rounds. I mean, their economy would have been way worse off. Rack is going to go down, and it will be 16-11, so no luck this time, unfortunately, for Penta. But if they had won one of those pistol rounds, actually, you could have seen a scoreline here in favoring the Germans. Very, very solid play coming out from Penta. And obviously, Na'Vi is just a strong team, so it could be kind of hard to deal with, but that's how it goes. The next game coming up, guys, Na'Vi are going to have to step it up a hell of a lot more than this, because they'll be playing the EMS1 Katowice Champions versus Pro. That game is coming up in about 5 minutes, so we don't have a lot of breaks here, just straight into it. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back. This next game is going to be an epic one, so you really want to stay tuned.